Unigine's tracker tool allows you to create keyframe animation to add dynamic gameplay elements or make in-game cinematic cutscenes. To open the tracker tool, choose Tools, Tracker from the main menu. Tracker window includes the following elements: track settings, tracks list, timeline panel, and graph view. The workflow is based on operating a set of tracks, each referring to a parameter animated over time. Tracker supports a wide range of parameters, from node position to material options and rendering settings. You can control cameras, lights, weather conditions, and a lot more. Representation of each parameter depends on its type. It can be a single track with float or integer values, like these render settings, or a set of tracks like node position composed of X, Y, and Z coordinates. Each track is composed of keyframes placed on the timeline. A keyframe is a snapshot of the parameter at a certain moment of time. Parameter values between keyframes are interpolated. Double-clicking on a keyframe will let you adjust its settings, time, value, and interpolation type. To play animation of all tracks once or in a loop, use the buttons in the bottom right corner. To toggle a track on and off, use the E button next to it. If we disable this track, the position of the camera won't change. The graph visualizes changes of parameter values over time. You can choose parameters to display by clicking the T button next to them. You can save the set of tracks as a track asset and load it later via the corresponding buttons. When a new track asset is loaded, it replaces the current set of tracks, so don't forget to save your changes. Let's create a simple animation first. Click Clear to delete all current tracks. We have a material ball, and we're going to make it move. Let's add parameters to be animated by clicking Add Parameter. In the window that opens, we choose the parameter type, Node Rotation, and we must define the node to bound the track to. We choose our material ball. We're going to rotate the ball around the Z-axis. There is a default keyframe in the beginning, so we need to add another by double-clicking on the timeline or on the graph. Now, we set rotation value for this keyframe to 360 degrees. We can also adjust the key value by dragging the point on the graph up and down. Let's play our track. Well, the ball rotates too fast. We can adjust playback limits and speed by clicking the gear button. These settings are applied to all tracks. If we set the unit time equal to 3, the animation will be played 3 times slower. Now let's add a track to change ball's position. Key positions are displayed in the scene viewport. You can see 3 arrow manipulators at the initial node position corresponding to the first keyframe. We can create a new keyframe by taking a snapshot from the editor. To do so, disable the target parameter track. Adjust the parameter via the editor, just like we do for position now. Then select the desired time for the keyframe on the timeline and click the key button. Then enable the track. New keys are created only for modified parameters. Y-coordinate in our case, that's why only one axis is displayed. We can enable manipulators for other axes by creating keyframes for X and Z coordinates. We can now easily adjust the trajectory we want. For fine synchronization, we can enable snapping mode for keyframes and timeline position by holding the Alt key when dragging them or via the magnet toggle. We can select and adjust multiple keyframes or clone them by dragging with the Shift key pressed. We can synchronize selected keyframes by setting the desired time or value in the corresponding field. We can use these buttons to set the transition mode. That's how parameter value changes between the selected keyframes. 5 modes are available. Constant mode. The value remains constant up to the next keyframe and abruptly changes. Linear interpolation. The value is linearly interpolated between the neighboring keyframes. Smooth interpolation by Bezier spline, with 2 control points for each keyframe. Interpolation by Bezier triangle also provides 2 control points for each keyframe, but can be used for sharp transitions. Automatic interpolation by Bezier spline. The curve is smoothed automatically. The last option is enough for our purposes. The tracker allows us to change material parameters over time, just like we animate the change of roughness, emission intensity, metalness, and microfiber parameters here. We can also change camera position and modify various render post effects. For example, the focal distance of the depth of field effect. By animating the sun rotation, we can create a time lapse when day turns into night. It can be used to create the day to night cycle at runtime. We can also make sequences or mix different track sets. In case if multiple tracks affect the same parameters, track blending allows us to define the degree of impact for each of them by setting weights. Suppose we've prepared several track animations with camera fly-throughs and time lapses. Now, let us combine them in a sequence. So we add the track parameter. Then we open the file selection dialog by double-clicking on the track line and select the first track for our sequence. We add keys for the time and value parameters. In the beginning, the time value should be set to 0 and weight should be set to 1. In the end, the time value should be set to 1. Thus, we match timing of the loaded track set with the current one. You can see how the camera position changes being affected by the first track set. Let's make playback speed 10 times slower. Then we do the same for second and third sets. Three animations now follow each other in the order we determined, but time values are not correct yet. So we create and adjust necessary time keyframes. It's easy to do it using the graph. We can also mix different animation sets to play them simultaneously. We have a separate track turning on the light at a certain moment. Let us mix it with the track sequence we created. We add a new track parameter and select the track that turns the light on. We set up keyframes for time and weight as we did before, and adjust the time when we want our light to turn on. Now, the two animations are played simultaneously. For detailed description of all the parameters of the tracker tool, please refer to our online documentation.